Hello there, photography enthusiasts. Welcome back to my channel. Today, we're embarking on a heartwarming journey as we restore an old photo of a lovely couple, a snapshot of their timeless love. However, there's a twist. The photo is marred by unwanted glass glare. But fear not, because in this tutorial, we're diving into the cutting edge tools of Photoshop. We'll be using the new restoration neural filter, the AI generative fill, and the versatile Liquify tool to restore this cherished memory to its former glory. So let's hop into the world of digital restoration magic. First things first, let's take a close look at the unwanted glass glare. We'll analyze the glare's position, intensity, and impact on the couple's photo. Understanding the extent of the challenge helps us plan our restoration strategy. Time to introduce our secret weapon, the restoration neural filter. This cutting-edge tool is designed to identify and repair damaged areas in images. Apply the filter and watch as it intelligently removes the glass glare while preserving the couple's features and expressions. Apply the neural filter. With the duplicated layer selected, go to the filter menu at the top. Look for a section related to neural filters or a specific restoration filter category. Select the appropriate filter for restoration or enhancement. If it's a new feature, there might be a specific restoration neural filter you have to download first if you never used before. I am downloading the same from this button. Adjust filter settings. A new dialog box or panel should appear with various settings and options. Experiment with the available sliders, options, and presets to fine-tune the filter's effect. There's usually a preview area that allows you to see the filter's effect on your image. Make adjustments until you're satisfied with how the restoration neural filter is handling the image. Once you're satisfied with the adjustments, apply the filter to your duplicated layer. Compare before and after. It's a good practice to toggle the visibility of the duplicated layer on and off to see the difference the restoration neural filter has made. Depending on the filter and your image, you might need to make further adjustments using standard Photoshop tools like brushes, masking, or adjustment layers. Save your work. If you're satisfied with the results, save your image. You can save it as a new file to keep both the original and the restored versions. I'm going to recreate that restoration process right here, right now, just for you. So why recreate something I've already done? Great question. The answer is simple. I want to show you every step, every technique, and every tool that I used to bring this image back to life. This way, you'll have a front row seat to the magic of digital restoration. Plus, you can follow along, learn the process, and maybe even apply some of these techniques to your own restoration projects. So, I have already opened a document that I have already restored. In first layer, I have already copied the restored image by using Neural Restore Filter. I did good job. It enhances the faces of couple, but not able to remove glass glare and washed out background. So before we dive into the exciting world of creativity, there's a pivotal step we must conquer first: selecting the subject. Now, head over to the left-hand toolbar and look for the Selects menu. Here, you'll find various tools that help you choose the subject you want to separate from the current background. In Photoshop, you might use the magic wand, quick selection tool, lasso tool, or even the pin tool. All of these are your allies in this task. So go to top option bar and click on select subject. Once your initial selection is in place, you need to type shortcut control J in Windows or command J in Mac. Selection will save in new transparent layer. Congratulations. With your subject selected, it's time to bring in the new background. In the upcoming steps, we'll uncover the various techniques that Photoshop offers to seamlessly merge your subject with its fresh environment, changing the background. But guess what? We're going to take things up a notch by using the AI generative fill, a powerful tool in Photoshop that can work wonders. Let's jump right in. All right. With your subject carefully selected, it's time to switch to the new contextual bar. From there, and this is where the magic happens, click Generative Fill from the Use Contextual bar. Type restaurant background now. Brace yourself for the AI generative fill to do its thing. Hit that OK button and watch as the AI generative fill takes center stage. It uses its magic to generate image data, creating a background that complements your subject perfectly. It gives 3 to 4 options. If you don't like these options, you can repeat the same steps to get new options. I have selected this. Once the AI generative fill has worked its wonders, you might want to give it a final touch. Zoom in, check for any minor discrepancies, and use tools like the clone stamp or healing brush to refine any areas that need a little extra attention. To look more realistic, I'm going to filter menu and select Gaussian blur add value 11 in radius box. It is according to requirement, and click OK. Now I am hiding this layer to make more changes on subject. To correct, man body that was completely ruined by the glare. I'm using again, generative fill after selecting man body and type black coat, and it gives 3 options with black coat. But I need black coat with bow that is in the original image. So I type again, black coat, white shirt with bow. The new options generated. I selected this one. Now, time to correct washout woman hair. So I made selection with pen tool according to the curves of the hair and type woman hair in contextual bar. Note when your selection is initialized. Generative fill will be shown on contextual bar. You will find many new generated options. So find that it's more appropriate. So I have repeated the same steps for man hair. After the AI generative fill has performed its magic, you may wish to add those finishing touches. Take a closer look by zooming in and keep an eye out for any tiny imperfections. Should you spot any discrepancies, fear not. Utilize helpful tools like the clone stamp or the healing brush to delicately enhance those areas that could use a bit more care. I also added plate on table with AI fill. Also added a purse in front of woman to cover washed area. After that, I'm going to correct woman right eye that was also washed out. I use pen tool and select the left eye area and copy to new layer and bring selection to right eye and create a black mask and use white brush to reveal and correct the affected area. Also, work on hair and corrected the right eyebrow of woman by cloning the left eyebrow with clone tool. Painted eye by sampling skin color and change the blending option to color. To add an extra touch of perfection, returning to the Liquify tool. This tool allows us to subtly adjust the couple's features, ensuring their natural beauty shines through. Use Liquify to refine small details and achieve a harmonious balance. To go to filter menu and select Liquify, gently drag the brush to tweak the face shape. If you're slimming down the cheeks or jawline, carefully pull them inward. If you're going for a more sculpted look, push the areas gently. After getting desired result, click OK. I am also doing small adjustments. Those I feel like here correcting the edges of arm. I notice that black coat is showing, but collar of the coat is not visible. So I used again pen tool and create the path of collar shape and make selection of path and type coat collar in generative fill box and selected a desired option that look more realistic. With the restoration almost complete, it's time to enhance the photo's overall appearance. Adjust the color balance, contrast, and brightness to create a captivating visual impact. Our goal is to evoke the emotions captured in this special moment. After correction, I have realized that face need more correction, because when we use Liquify tool, then we are not able to see the original image. So I copied the original image above the last layer and selected the man face and copy to new transparent layer. Create a snapshot by using Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E in Windows or Command Shift as option, E in the Mac. The new layer has both faces. I convert this layer to Smart Object layer. In Photoshop, a smart object is a powerful and flexible layer type that allows you to work with raster and vector graphics while maintaining the original image's quality and editability. Smart objects enable non-destructive editing and provide various advantages, especially when it comes to resizing, transforming, and applying filters. So go to Filter menu and select Liquify. Now Liquify Workspace. You can see the original and edited image. So I made changes according to the original image. Click OK. Now I need to remove original image. So I have already created a duplicated A layer of original image and added black mask on liquified layer and painted over the face with white brush and removed the original image. Zoom out and appreciate the transformation. A beautiful glare. Free portrait of the loving couple. Compare the before and after to witness the incredible restoration journey we've embarked upon. And there you have it. A timeless love story restored to its full splendor. Thanks to the Restoration Neural Filter, AI Generative Fill, and the trusty Liquify tool, we've rescued this precious memory from the grip of unwanted glass glare. If you found this tutorial inspiring, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe for more creative endeavors, and don't forget to hit that notification bell. Share your thoughts and experiences in the comments below. Until next time, keep preserving and cherishing those beautiful moments.